What's up, coders? In this video, I'm gonna show you how you can download an editor on your phone. In case you don't have a laptop or your laptop is bad, instead of just holding your hands or sitting down there waiting, you can start coding right on your phone. Nothing's gonna be that easy, but it shows your determination to learn. So let me tell you about Acode. Acode is an open source program. Acode is a lightweight yet powerful code editor and web IDE for Android. You can use this editor for editing HTML, JavaScript, text. You can create a website, run the website in the browser, and see errors or log in the console. Also, edit any kind of source files like Python, CSS, HTML, Java, JavaScript, Dart, and etc. Note, you cannot run programs other than HTML, Markdown, and JavaScript, which means you cannot run Python, PHP, Java, C, and C++, etc. But you can use Tamog alongside a code to run this program. Okay, so that's cool. So some of the features that a code has is no ads, edit any file from your device, GitHub support, /SFTP support, supporting tag highlighting for 100 programming language, dozens of themes, user friendly, in-app HTML/Markdown preview, interactive JavaScript console, in-app file browser, open source, support 5,000 lines, fast workflow, open more than one file, customizable keyboard shortcut, file recovery, and file management. Okay guys, so this is the IDE we are going to install on your phone.
Let's go right into it. We're going to come to Play Store, click on it. So they say that we have to open it up, but if you've not opened it up already, you just come to the search right here and type in a code okay, to enter. So this is it, a code. So let's click on it on the top part right here. Okay, and click on download. Okay, so I'm downloading it. Okay, now it's done installing, so we're gonna click on open. We want to allow a code to access photo media and files. Just click allow.
Okay, right here it says if editor is not working properly, try these suggestions. We have three suggestions. Now says turn off keyboard autocorrect settings. Then number two, use Gboard or Akka's keyboard. Then number three, please read FAQ.
So you press OK. We're going to come to Play Store. Click on it. So they say that for to open it up, but if you have not opened it up already, you just come to the search right here and type in a code. Okay, to enter. So this is it, a code. So let's click on it on the top part right here. Okay, and click on download. Okay, so I'm downloading it. Okay, now it's done installing, so we're gonna click on open. We're going to allow a code to access photo media and files. Just click allow.
Okay, right here it says if editor is not working properly, try these suggestions. We have three suggestions. Now says turn off keyboard autocorrect settings. Then number two, use Gboard or Akka's keyboard. Then number three, please read FAQ.
So you press OK. So this is what you're gonna see when you open the Acode app. First, we're gonna create a folder. Come to the three lines on the left hand side, click on them. Now open the open folder, click on this. Yeah, So we have two places where we can store our files in our phone memory or our SD card. So I'm going to use my SD card. So this is all the files in my SD card. So let's create a folder. Okay, come to the plus up here. So right here you can create a new file, new folder or new project. So I want to create a new folder. So let's let me give it a name, HTML project. Okay, so let's look for it. This it, click on it. So right here I can click on the plus. I can create a file in here now if I want to. So let's click on file. Let's call it, usually when you're naming your file, you're meant to call the first one index dot have an extension of HTML. But I noticed sometimes you may have an issue trying to preview your code. I'm just gonna name it first. That's HTML. Okay. But if you are going to upload it to GitHub, you need to change it to index.html. Then let's click on select folder. So we can come to the three lines on top, click on it, then click on the folder. You can see the file we created, click on it. That's it. Another way you can create a file is by clicking the three dots on the right side. You can see you can save file, open recent file, you can upload to GitHub. So let's click on new file. Let's call this home dot html. So save it. Okay, so this is another way you can create a file. Okay, so those are the two ways you can create a file. You notice once we are done creating a file, we have this play button appear on the top. That's very important so that you can preview your code. So let me paste in the code that I have already paste. So this is our code that we just pasted in. We're going to save it. If you notice this yellow line, it appears when you are typing and you have not saved your work. So once you click save, yep, then click the folder again, then it's saved. To preview what we have done so far, just click on the play head. We have two options to preview it. We can use our browser or in app. So click browser first. So you can see hello world. Okay, I think I have an error because I have another H1 shown at the side that should not show. But let's go back. Then if I also want to, I can preview it in app. Click on this. So this is how it looks in app. So click the X. Okay. So right down here you can see the arrows all around. So let's click on this little arrow here. Yeah. Let's click here. Oh yeah. So that little arrow now expands and shows us the order options it has. So let me talk about it. Starting from the first one here, the arrow with a mark at the front. So if you click here, see what it did right now. But we can easily go back by clicking this other arrow here. Click again. That turns everything normal. We can, the small arrows underneath can be used to move to the left. You can see easily moving. We can move to the right. Okay, that's our delete button that moved that up there. Let's move it back down. Now enter button, once click on enter, it creates a space and move the tag down. So if you want to move a old tag like the h1 with the yellow word in it, you notice this arrow facing up or down with an M at the side. Just click on the arrow with the M facing up. You notice it moved that tag up. Press it again. So it moves the old tag, the old line of tag. Then you can move it back down. Down. You can make a copy of it also by clicking on this other arrow with a C, which means copy. You can make a copy on top. The one arrow facing down makes a copy underneath. But it all looks the same thing, but it's a little different. We can undo all this by clicking this arrow here. So right now, we can save it again. Notice the yellow mark right here. Saved. So we also have our shift right here. Then we have our the pencil icon. Once we click on it, we can cut, copy, paste, see more. We can search. You can go to a specific line in the code depending how long your code is. You can go to a specific line, go to line, the format, and more. Now, after the pencil, I want to come back to the three lines. Let me show you some things about it. So click on it. So right here, after clicking on the HTML project, we can see the files in it came out. Then we can delete any of the files we don't want again by giving a long press on it. See? So give you the long press, we can copy, cut, rename, and delete. Right here. So let's go back. And also, if you press this arrow right here, you can also totally minimize the bottom menu. Kind of like removing it away. So these are just the basic feature of Acode and how the features work. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. Bye.
Hi, if you're not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. Click the red button underneath the video that says subscribe. Thanks.